Now the next theorem is Pythagoras theorem. Statement is, in a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of remaining two sides. You prove here this theorem. Statement is given. According to statement, I draw the right angle triangle ABC in which angle B is 90 degree. Hence, from given figure, I write in triangle ABC, angle B is equal to 90 degree, means right angle triangle given. Now, what to prove? The square of the hypotenuse, here angle B 90 degree, its opposite side AC is the hypotenuse. Square of this hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of remaining two sides, means AB and BC are the remaining two sides. Square of AB means AB square plus BC square. You prove this here. Now, for this proof, you construct, draw BD perpendicular to AC. Draw BD perpendicular to AC. Hence, I write here, draw segment BD perpendicular to hypotenuse AC. ADC betweenness. ADC betweenness. Now, proof. What is given in the figure? In triangle ABC, angle B 90 degree, this is given. Again, BD perpendicular to AC, according to construction, this is given. If in a right angle triangle, the perpendicular drawn to the hypotenuse, then you use the theorem of similarity and right angle triangle. Hence, you show the original triangle ABC, this triangle ABC, similar triangle ADB, similar triangle BDC. Hence, I write here triangle ABC similar triangle ADB, similar triangle BDC by similarity and right angle triangle, by similarity and right angle triangle theorem. Now, name this equation first. From equation first, you write here triangle ABC similar triangle ADB. From first. Now, you know, if two triangles are similar, then its corresponding sides are in proportion. Hence, I write here AB and AD, corresponding sides. AB upon AD, this is equal to BC upon this BC upon DB. This is equal to AC upon AB, AC upon AB. corresponding sides of a similar triangle. Now, what you find here? This AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. In three ratios, here AB present, here also AB present. You cancel this ratio. Therefore, by cross multiplication, AB into AB, first you write that AB upon AD, this is equal to AC upon AB. Therefore, AB into AB, AB square AB into AB, AB square is equal to AD into AC, equation first, AD into AC. Similarly, triangle ABC, similar triangle BDC. Triangle ABC, similar triangle BDC. I name this equation number 2 here because this is the first equation 2. Now, the sides are in proportion. Here AB upon BD, this is equal to BC upon DC, this is equal to AC upon BC. Corresponding sides of similar triangle. Corresponding sides of similar triangle. Here, BC, BC in both the ratio present, hence you take these two ratios only. BC into BC, BC square. This is equal to AC into DC, AC into DC. Name equation 3. Name equation 3. Now, what you want here? AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Hence, I add this equation 2 and equation 3. By adding, equation 2 and 3. What we get here? LHS AB square, it's LHS BC square. AB square plus BC square, this is equal to this AD into AC plus AC into DC. Now, LHS plus LHS is equal to RHS plus RHS. Here AD into AC plus AC into DC, AC is common in both the terms. AC is the common, hence you write AC is the common factor is equal to what remain? AD plus DC. AD plus DC, AC is a common factor I write here, AD plus DC. Next, this is equal to AC as it is into AD plus DC. In the figure, this AD plus DC is equal to total AC. Hence, I write here AC. This is equal to, you write the reason here, ADC betweenness, ADC betweenness, AD plus DC total AC by betweenness. Therefore, AC into AC, AC square. Therefore, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Hence, the Pythagoras theorem is proved. Now, the next theorem is converse of Pythagoras theorem. You just studied the Pythagoras theorem, in which in a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of remaining two sides. It's converse. What is the converse of Pythagoras theorem? In a triangle, here not in a right angle triangle, in a triangle, if the square of one side is equal to the sum of the squares of the remaining two sides, then the triangle is right angle triangle. According to given statement, I draw the triangle ABC. From this triangle ABC, I write the given. In triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, square of the one side means I take this AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. This is given. Square of one side is equal to the sum of the squares of the remaining two sides. Then this angle B is a right angle. Therefore, I write here angle B is equal to 90 degree. Means triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. Now, I draw the triangle PQR. In construction, draw triangle PQR such that angle Q 90 degree, AB equal to PQ, and BC is equal to QR. Hence, I draw the triangle PQR in this way, triangle PQR, angle Q 90 degree, this AB is equal to PQ and BC is equal to QR. Now, proof, how to prove it? First, I take this triangle PQR. In triangle PQR, angle Q 90 degree, and you know, if triangle is right angle triangle, then by Pythagoras theorem, what you write here? This PR square, hypotenuse square, is equal to PQ square plus QR square by Pythagoras theorem. This is equal to, means PR square is equal to, instead of PQ, I substitute here AB. AB is equal to PQ given. Therefore, I write here AB square plus, instead of QR, QR is equal to BC in construction. Therefore, I write here BC square. You write from construction, Understand? This is a equation number 1. Again, what is given? This AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square given. Hence, I write here AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square, equation 2 given. Now, from equation 1 and 2, right hand sides equal, hence left sides also equal. PR square is equal to AC square from 1 and 2. Now, taking square root on both sides, we get PR is equal to AC. Taking square roots on the both sides. Understand? Okay. In figure, AB is equal to PQ, BC is equal to QR. Again, what to prove here? PR is equal to AC. Name this equation 3. All the corresponding sides are congruent here. AB congruent to PQ, BC QR, AC PR. Hence, these two triangles are congruent by SSS tests. Hence, I write here in this way, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, segment AB congruent to segment PQ, segment BC congruent to segment QR. This is given. From construction, and last segment AC congruent to segment PR from 3. Therefore, what happened? therefore triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR by SSS congruent test. Two triangles are congruent, then its corresponding angles also congruent. Hence I write here angle B congruent to angle Q, that is, but this angle Q is 90 degree, but angle Q 90 degree, therefore angle B also 90 degree. Hence triangle ABC is right angled triangle. Theorem is true. Dear students, you study about the Pythagoras theorem and its converse. Now you solve the examples on Pythagoras theorem and its converse. Practice set 2.1, in which question number 6, what that given? The diagonal of a square is 10 cm given. You find side and perimeter of a square. You know the square in which all sides are equal. Let I draw the quadrilateral ABCD is a square. All angles are equals 90 degree. Now in triangle ABC, this angle B is equal to 90 degree. Again AB is equal to BC, means two sides are congruent, then its opposite angles, BC its opposite angle, this A, BAC, AB its opposite angle, ACB, opposite angles also congruent by isosceles triangle theorem. Here angle, this angle is 90 degree, therefore the sum of angle BAC and angle BCA 90 degree, but these angles are equal, hence both are 45 degree, both are 45 degree, therefore triangle ABC is 45 degree, 90 degree triangle. Now if you use this 45 degree, 90 degree triangle, then the side making right angles, means AB, BC, these are equals, is equal to 1 upon root 2 into hypotenuse. Here hypotenuse is the diagonal, this AC is a diagonal, hence you write AB, BC are the sides of square, therefore I write here side of a square, this is equal to 1 upon root 2 into diagonal, means diagonal upon root 2, according to 45 45 90 degree. Therefore I substitute the value, diagonal 10 upon root 2. Now the denominator is root 2, you rationalize it. Rationalize it means this root 2 is a rationalizing agent, therefore 10 into root 2 upon root 2 into root 2, means you multiplied and divide by root 2, this ratio, therefore 10 root 2 upon root 2 into root 2, 2, 2 ones are 2, 2 fives are 10, therefore 5 root 2 centimeter. This is the side of a square, means this side is 5 root 2 centimeter, 5 root 2 centimeter. Again you solve this example by using Pythagoras theorem. If you take AB and BC are x, or you also solve this, or quadrilateral ABCD is a square in which AB is equal to BC is equal to X, I take here. Angle ABC is equal to 90 degree and AC 10 centimeter, this is given. Therefore, in triangle ABC, angle B 90 degree, in this triangle, in triangle ABC, angle B 90 degree, by Pythagoras theorem, AC square, hypotenuse square, is equal to sum of the squares of remaining two sides by Pythagoras theorem. Now, substitute the values. AC is 10 given, 10 square. This is equal to x square plus x square, square of 10, 100. X square plus x square, 2x square. Hence, x square is equal to 100 upon 2. Therefore, x square is equal to 50. Now, taking square root on both sides, this x square, x is equal to under root of 50, x square, taking square root x here, x square is square root x, this is equal to square root of 50, this is equal to 25 to the 50 is equal to 25 is a perfect square, its square root is 5, 5 root 2 centimeter, therefore AB is equal to BC is equal to 5 root 2 centimeter. Understand? Means side of a square is 5 root 2 centimeter. According to 45, 45, 90 degree, I find the side 5 root 2 centimeter. Therefore, to directly write side of a square, 1 diagonal upon root 2 in this way or by Pythagoras theorem. Now, the next, what you find here? Perimeter of a square. Perimeter of a square is equal to four into side four. What is the side? 5 root 2. Therefore, 4 5 are 20 root 2 centimeter. Therefore, last you write the answer. Side of a square, 5 root 2 centimeter. And perimeter is equal to 20 root 2 centimeter. Now, the next question is 9 in practice set 2.1. A figure is given in this way, in which in triangle PQR, angle R 90 degree given, point M is midpoint of side QR, this is given. From that, to prove here, PQ square, this is equal to 4PM square minus 3PR square. Now, proof. First, point M is midpoint of side QR, this is given. Therefore, I write here RM is equal to MQ, RM is equal to MQ, or 2RM is equal to RQ. I write here 2RM is equal to RQ, equation first. Now, in triangle PRM, this angle R is equal to 90 degree, 90 degree. Therefore, you know the Pythagoras theorem, square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of remaining two sides. Hence, I write here PM square, hypotenuse square, this is equal to PR square plus RM square by Pythagoras theorem. You write full statement here, by Pythagoras theorem. Now from this I find the value of RM square, PM square minus PR square. Equation 2, I transfer this PR square at this side, PM square minus PR square, equation 2. Now in triangle PRQ, what you find here, PQ square. Hence I use triangle PRQ by Pythagoras theorem. In triangle PRQ, angle R 90 degree by Pythagoras theorem, here PQ is the hypotenuse, therefore I write here PQ square is equal to PR square plus RQ square, PR square plus RQ square. Now PQ square as it is, this PR square also as it is, plus RQ square. From 3, value of RQ is 2RM, I substitute here 2RM, RQ 2RM bracket square. From equation 1, from equation 1. Now PR square plus square of 2 is 4, RM its square, this is equal to PR square, I write as it is, plus 4 times the value of RM square you find in equation 2. RM square is equal to PM square minus PR square. Hence I substitute this value here, PM square minus PR square. From equation 2, from equation 2. Now this PQ square is equal to PR square plus, remove this bracket, 4 into PM square minus 4 into PR square. Now this PQ square as it is, I write this term first, 4 PM square plus PR square minus 4 PR square. PR square, 4 PR square, like terms. 4 PM square as it is, here PR square minus 4 PR square, subtraction of this, coefficient of this PR square is 1 minus this 4, means 1 minus 4 is 3. Hence I write here minus 3 PR square, minus 3 PR square. Therefore this PQ square is equal to 4 PM square minus 3 PR square. Now the next example is in problem set 2, question number 2, which depends on the converse of Pythagoras theorem. Here two sides 7 cm, 24 cm, 25 cm form a right angle triangle, give reason. Means 7, 24, 25 are the sides of a triangle. The triangle is right angle triangle or not. Now here 7, 24, 25, in which 25 is the longest side. Hence I write here longest side, its square, this is equal to 25 square, this is equal to 625, equation first. Second, 724 means sum of the squares of remaining two sides. Which are the remaining two sides? 7 its square, 24 its square. Now square of 7 is 49 and square of 24 is what, that 576. This is equal to 625, equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, 25 square is equal to 625 and this 7 square plus 24 square is equal to also 625. Therefore, 25 square is equal to 7 square plus 24 square from 1 and 2. Therefore, by converse of Pythagoras theorem given, triangle is right angle triangle. Understand? By converse of Pythagoras theorem, you solve in this way the examples.